Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Navyashree from Heritage Club, and I'll be hosting this event for the day. I welcome you all to the Heritage Center Day of IIT Madras. On this pleasant day, we have with us our Honorable Director, Professor Bhaskar Ramamurthy, other honorable dignitaries, and our speakers for the day, Professor M. Ravindran and Dr. S. Ponnarasu. Heritage of a particular region is not just because of the history of that region, but also because of the present. Therefore, we, the people of Heritage Club of IIT Madras, have come together to preserve the heritage of our prestigious campus and to present it to the future generations. On this note, I invite Professor R. Nagarajan to address the gathering and deliver his welcome message.
Good evening and welcome to everyone for this edition of Heritage Center Day. I said last year's was a special edition because it happened during our Diamond Jubilee year. Well, the Diamond Jubilee is still continuing, so this is also a special Diamond Jubilee edition of Heritage Center Day. And it's good to see so many of you, so many of our former faculty, so many of our alumni, so many of our current faculty, and most importantly, so many student volunteers. We are finally starting to get traction among the students to get them interested in our heritage activities, and I'm very optimistic that they'll play a key role in the development of this heritage center. We have lots of plans to make this center as appealing, as world-class as possible, and I'm sure that by the time you come here next year, actually I wish you would come more frequently, but certainly by this time next year you will see tremendous changes in this center.
So I must start with this confession. So my drawing teacher is here, Professor Shanmugam. Right, and we had to do all these drawings when you were in the BTech program here, and the drawings always had this thing at the bottom where you had to fill in this HTTP, HTML. It's interesting that all of us saw it as something you just have to do, never asked what it is, never knew what it is, okay, just wrote it down, and years later I found out what they stood for after I came back as a faculty member and became a dean, then I had to understand what it was. Otherwise, for people from other departments, this is just meaningless acronyms that if you don't fill, he'll cut marks. Okay, so we filled it up. In any case, subsequently this HTTP lab 2 years ago, you know, our second master plan identified that many of the labs that are in that entire stretch occupy a large footprint with a low utilization ratio because they're all single-story, double-story buildings, and that those are the ones we have to demolish and rebuild as multi-story buildings as we grow. So time came for us to identify where to start in that process, and unfortunately the axe fell on HTTP lab, HTML lab, and of course we had to entice the current occupants by giving them some nice building separately and something, and so anyway Diman and others cooperated. So then the second large academic building that we are building in the as part of the second master plan is coming up there now. However, some of the parts of lab setups that continue to be used and are important have been moved to another place.
Professor M. Ravindran joined as faculty in Department of Mechanical Engineering of IIT Madras in 1969 and was deputed to Technical University in Munich of Germany during the period of 1972 to 1974 for advanced research in hydraulic machinery.
Came here to IIT Madras in 1959 at the age of about 36. He was born in 1923, and now he had to go to war during 42-45 before he could even write the final exam of the high school. He came from the war, did that, then worked in the industry for some time, and joined the famous Friedler Institute of Turbo Machinery in the University of Braunschweig. At that time, I joined as a, not as a faculty, as a technical teacher trainee. I mean, at that time, the government of India had a special program to select few people and train them as teachers so that they can go back and work as a faculty elsewhere in engineering colleges. That was a program of government of India. So very, very realistic in nature. Like, for example, there is a turbine in the hydraulic power plant. It gets damaged, you replace with some other turbine not of the same specification. What will happen to the overall performance, efficiency of the whole power plant, etc., etc., power output, etc. Like that, we used to start at 8 o'clock, go up to 9:30, 10 o'clock. was purely voluntary. Like that, he taught the students what they need to become a good engineer. And he meticulously, because this type of approach of integrated teaching of all turbo machinery, pumps, turbines, everything was not available in literature because they are all in a different mode, different units. He started using the SI system for the first time in 1966. And he said, I will prepare the notes. He himself typed the two lecture notes of almost 200 pages. I have the notes still here. He typed on a tracing sheet, took blueprint. Those days there was no computer, there was no other thing. He typed himself on this blueprint, took blueprints and distributed to students free of cost. So he said, all the sketches there, he himself made, because he was a good man drawing, meticulous details. He said, anything what is on the drawing board cannot be a loose sketch. It should be proportionate, it should be very clear to the students. Like that, he was an excellent teacher.
Our work will facilitate the understanding of the history and functioning of IIT Madras, as well as its contribution to the growth and of science and technology in India. The archive will organize and preserve the historical records of IIT Madras. It will also preserve personal papers of former faculty, staff and students. It will regulate access to these records. Currently, records are in unorganized or semi-organized form in different levels of deterioration and dispersed in various locations of IIT Madras, which we will organize using archival standards. Further, this organized records will have a catalog available in searchable online database where users can access it readily. Though the idea is very simple, the process of organizing and make it searchable requires careful planning and execution. In order to achieve this, Dr. Roran, the faculty advisor and principal investigator of the archive project, has formulated certain steps to follow. Survey, archive plan and policy, building plan and infrastructure, web presence for the archive, public presence for the archive, exhibitions, lectures based on the records. Progressing with the survey, this will help us in sorting the records with reference to quantity, condition and content and creating a retention schedule. Drafting archiving policy will define the mandate of the archive, access and other procedures. Planning building and infrastructure, assessing requirements with reference to both external area requirement and internal space compartmentalization and financial estimates.
What happened here? I was just sitting in my room in Kaveri, and suddenly I am here with a T square.
Okay.
Are you going? Yeah. The director.
No, the director.
No, he's the director.
He was the director.
No, he's the director. He's the only director. Wait, this is some other college, right? This
no,
is
not no, no, no.
He's the director of IIT Madras. I know that.
We are still in IIT Madras inside Chennai.
Chennai? What is Chennai? Wait, you know why IIT Madras is called IIT Madras, right? Because it is in Madras.
That is true. But, you know, we have changed the name from Madras to Chennai.
I think many universities have different campuses, like branches. So this is like some secondary branch. The main branch is in Madras, no?
No. This is the main. This is the only branch. Okay. It is called IIT Madras, but it is inside the city, Chennai. We have changed the name of the city to Chennai.
Whoa, so much has changed. Yeah. Are the... Is Schroeder still here?
Schroeder is definitely there. So we have maintained your legacy. See, we are today, in fact, we are celebrating your legacy.
2020, that's like 60 years in the future.
Yes.
There are still two also, right? Krishna Kaveri?
No, there are 20 actually, more than 20.
20 hostels?
Yes.
What do you do with 20 hostels? There are like 100 people in my batch.
You know, as I say, count on the fingers of one hand, almost on the finger of one finger, as I say. But now it has grown so much now, it's become extremely inclusive. And I think that all of you are, in a sense, members of Team Heritage Center. So the question arises, do we thank ourselves in a vote of thanks? Even so, it's my present duty to thank those of you, those who have helped organize this program today and those who have participated in it. Thanks first to the speakers, Professor Ravindran and to Dr. Purnarasin.